Welcome to Cinema News, the one and only Ricky Lee. Hi, Sir Ricky.
Hi, Bianca.
Hi, how are you?
Okay naman, stuck in the house but doing a lot of work.
Oh, still very, very busy. And thank you so much for your time, for taking time out for this interview. And we do want to talk about that work that you mentioned because more than two decades since it was published, the book Trip to Quiapo is now on iWant TFC as a docu-series. So I'm just curious to know yung backstory nito. How was this project presented to you?
2-3 years ago pa to, na gusto nilang gawing series, gawing show yung project sina Jeannie. So matagal siya, matagal na proseso. It was a back and forth. Ganito kaya, until finally nag-gel. So yun, it took years. And I got excited agad-agad kasi I wanted something accessible. Di ba? Yung nasa libro, magiging audio-visual na siya. And they wanted it accessible, relatable, maintindihan maski nang hindi gustong magsulat, basta mahilig lang sa kwento. So, yeah, it was very exciting when they presented it to me.
I personally find it intriguing kasi it's both a docu.
Yes.
But at the same time, there is a narrative component.
Yes. Yes.
Which is what Enchong is part of.
Para siyang docudrama in the sense na workshop siya, may sessions ako with some workshoppers, and then merong gusto maging writer, si Julio Manunulat, played by Enchong D. We follow him, going to Quiapo, going home, and then trying to write, and then we go into the story he's forming in his mind, kung ano yung kwento yung binubuo niya. So maraming levels siya.
How does it feel to have this book that you wrote way, way back be a required reading in school? It's like a manual of the next generation of writers. Siyempre, is this part of the vision when you wrote it?
No, hindi. Nang sinulat ko lang yun, the only thing I was thinking was, nung nagsimula akong magsulat, walang workshops, walang manuals, nothing like this, walang film courses in schools. So, I didn't know where to go. Ayun lang nasip ko. So, kaya gumawa kaya ako ng libro na tutulong sa mga gaya ko before. Ayun lang. And also because I was doing workshops already for about what? For about a decade, 1998. More than na. So, sabi ko parang magandang i-put together yung results ng mga workshops ko. And then, so the book. Pero I didn't realize na magagamit pala siya ang text book sa maraming MASCOM courses and film courses. Hindi ko alam na tatagal yung buhay niya up to now.
Let's take a little trip down memory lane. Fresh from Bicol, and then you went to Manila. How was your first trip to Quiapo? What was that feeling?
Well, I'll have to go back farther than that. Growing up in Bicol, reading magazines, comics, laging parang if you go to Manila and if you go to Quiapo, doon matutupad yung mga dreams mo. So, nagkaroon ako ng idea na I want to be somebody. Gusto kong mahabol yung dreams ko. And para magawa ko yun, I have to go to Quiapo. Nandun siya, yung culmination. Kaya nung makarating ako ng Maynila, ang una kong hinanap, Quiapo, billboards, wala naman sa Dait noon eh. Sa Bicol eh. Big billboards, buildings, and then simbahan, mga manghula, lahat ng klase ng tao nandun eh. Lahat ng ibinebenta from Himala to mga gamot, to herbs, to hula, etc. Nandun lahat ng klase ng tao. So parang, I was lost, but at the same time, I found myself na, ay, this is home. Pero madali ka rin mawala at maligaw, pero enjoy ito. So yun. So naging malaking bagay na sa akin ng Quiapo. Like when I was studying in UP, nakakapagsulat kasi ako pag mobile ako. I'm a mobile person. I don't want to get stuck. I cannot focus. I keep moving around even when I'm writing. So nung nag-aaral ako sa UP at nakatira ako sa Nara dorm, I would take bus rides from UP to Quiapo, back and forth. Hindi ako bumababa. Doon ako nagsusulat sa bus. And marami akong nasusulat sa bus, notes sa papel ko rito. Gumagalaw yung utak ko pag gumagalaw ako physically. So ilang bus rides, UP, Quiapo. That's why trip to Quiapo, eventually. That's why I keep telling people na it's the trip, not the destination. It's the journey that's going to produce all those stories. Bonus na lang yung destination.
You mentioned kanina, Sir Ricky, that you like moving. You're very mobile. Yes. When you write, you have to be moving. But obviously now we cannot move. Yeah. How have you been coping during this quarantine then?
Nung nagsimula yung pandemic, nagpanik ako. Kasi I cannot stay put eh. Every single day I have to go out. And when I write, I'm mobile. I go down, so ground floor, I come up, and chatara, Trip To Quiapo. I have to keep moving. I play rock music because it drives me. Then suddenly pandemic, I have to stay put. At may panic attacks ako. Yung anxiety attack, may ganun ako ganun. So, nung una, nagpanic ako ng konti. Then ininisip ko, I have to do something. What's the best thing that I can do? What's the thing that I do best? Well, it's writing. So doon ako kumapit. Kumapit ako sa what I do best. And nung kumapit ako doon, ginawa ko siyang ritual. I have to write every single day, every morning. Mechanically, I have to fake myself into thinking that I'm doing well, I'm writing, I feel at home. Eventually, na-fake ko yung mind ko, naniwala siya na, ay, Ricky's okay. Every morning he writes. Every time may nasusulat ako na maganda, nare-reassure ako, na-empower ako. And so I kept writing. So I was able to finish, 4-5 scripts during this pandemic. And aside from 4-5 workshops online na nag-overlap, ongoing, and then I'm finishing a book. So I realized, ang dami ko pang na-accomplish pala ngayong pandemic kesa noon na natutokso akong lalabas, pupunta akong saan-saan dito dahil I was forced to stay put. Ang dami kong nasulat. And sa dami ng nasusulat ko, nai-inspire ako lalo to stay put and to keep writing. So as I said, I think I did very well.
So from moving around, it became at home writing. But yes. Did you do, Sir Ricky, any side hobbies? Like, syempre, nauso ngayon ng plants, cooking, baking. May ganun po ba kayo, Sir Ricky?
Hindi. What I ended up doing was watching all the K-dramas. At ng series ng mga married couple and Taiwan class and Okay Not To Be Okay and Crash Landing and etc.
Okay, from a Ricky Lee point of view, ano ang paborito niyo, sir, na K-drama of all that you've watched?
Itaiwan class. Tayong mga Pilipino and ako, I can identify with the lead character, yung guy, the passion, the commitment, yung hindi nawala, unwavering niyang pagmamahal, unwavering niyang devotion dun sa honor niya, dun sa kailangan ibangon, pagiganti man yung tawag dun, hindi. Nakakommit siya dun all throughout, all the time. Hindi siya nag-waver at all. It was done really, really well. Mm-hmm. Hinihintay ko yung kailan ba luluhod ito? Kailan ba siya luluhod? Ang dami kong hinihintay. So, pinapanood ko siya. Hindi ako makapaghintay. Napanoorin yung kasunod at kasunod at kasunod.
Yeah. It's so refreshing to know na, wow, you like Itaewon class. Parang, oh, we have something in common, Sir Ricky. Well, you have written so many iconic material. Was there ever a time na napagod magsulat ang isang Ricky Lee? And how did you overcome that period?
Yung nung early years ko in the movies, madalas. Kasi hindi ko pa masyadong masakyan yung takbo sa industriya, yung pagka-showbiz niya, the attention that you get. I don't, mahihiyain akong tao, and yet I'm in a profession that pays attention to you. So, medyo may ganun-ganun ako nung una. So, may mga duda-duda pa ako. And then, there were occasions when parang dry, walang assignments. Naalala ko, nagkagantong kami ni Lino Broca. Ba't walang mga dumarating na assignments? Baka dapat gumawa na tayo ng action movie para makakuha tayo ng assignments. So, yun yung mga panahon na I wanted to quit writing in the movies. Pero after that, never ko nang inisip na gusto kong mag-quit. Na-realize ko na there's nothing else that I can do. There's nothing else na gusto kong gawin. At saka hindi naman ako marunong magluto o magsayaw o kumanta o magtayo ng bahay o manggamot. So, right. And so, it's not something I choose to do anymore. It's something that I do like breathing. I write and I breathe and I live. So, hindi ko na nahihiwalay. So, it's no longer a decision.
Sir Ricky, in our industry, ang laking bagay nung audience research, market research, and ang gusto ng tao, social listening. How do you marry giving the audience what they want and offering them something new na kakaiba, na hindi ka sure kung tatanggapin, pero kailangan masabi yung story na to?
I have to respect my audience. hindi ko pwedeng isipin na bobo ang audience ko. Hindi ko pwedeng sabihin wala silang alam. Ang pwede ko lang sabihin, maybe hindi pa sila prepared dun sa klase ng kwento o pagkukwento na gagawin ko, or hindi pa sila exposed, but it doesn't mean bobo sila o hindi nila alam. So, sisimulan ko sa need nila. I'll start from their position, vantage point. Ano ang need nila? Kung may need sila, kung ano man ang feeling nila na may need sila, halimbawa to belong, well, I'll create a character who wants to belong. That means nakakabit na ako sa kanila. Then ko ipapasok yung need ko naman na gusto kong ikwento sa kanila at gusto kong sabihin. And a case in point is the I Want series that we're doing now, the Trip to Quiapo series. But we wanted something na accessible, relatable sa mga manunood, maski na hindi sila writers. And so we started from there. Anong makakapitan nila, anong maintindihan nila? We go emotions. Kasi emotion naman basic eh. Walang mataas, walang mababa. So the feeling na incomplete ka as a human being, hindi ka buo. Eh, that's true with everybody, writer ka, hindi writer, character ka, totoong tao ka. So that's one of the points na pinagsimula namin dun sa series.
We would like to invite a very special guest to join this conversation. Hello, Martin Claro, all the way from San Jose, Rizal.
Yeah, hi! Hi again.
Hello po, Ms. Bianca. Sir Ricky, I'm so honored na nakita ko po kayo ulit. I have one question in line with the upcoming series po. I've been wanting to ask you since super fan niyo po ako, way, way back, ano po yung top three po na movies or any ginawa niyo po, top three na akda niyo na talagang paborito niyo tsaka mapagmamalaki niyo?
That's both easy and not easy to answer. I'm easy sure. Because of my head, I can always mention not just 3, 5, or 7, or even 10. Not easy because I keep changing. Buti na lang tatlo. Moral is very close to me because buhay ko yun at ang mga kaibigan ko na nakalagay doon, composite. Himala because up to now, buhay pa siya. Naging kung ano na ng permutations niya, musical, book, and so on and so forth. Jose Rizal, also, yun. Pero baka magbago yun, Toto, after a few days. That's siguro, but maybe Himala will always be, Himala moral will always be there, I think, whatever ranking.
Thank you very much, Martin, and thank you for joining us. I'm curious dun sa mga new generation directors. Sinong vision ang gusto nyo na yung style nila, type mo, na hopefully they get to work with you in the future?
Actually, I'm getting to work with them already. Most of them. Yung mga bagong generation and some of them workshoppers ko. I have a project with Mikael Red, Trev Monteras, and so on. Wala pa akong project kina Dwayne, kina Giancarlo. Sila, I would want to work with them. Ang swerte ko eh, I've worked with Lino and Bernal and Marilu and Mike De Leon. And then now I'll be working with sina Trev at sina Mikael at sina Dwayne, sina Paolo Villaluna, and so on. Parang ang swerte-swerte ko naman.
Ako, swerte din kami as an audience to have your work interpreted by the icons in the new generation.
Yeah, yeah.
So thank you that you don't stop writing. And I'm just curious, kasi you've been writing so many years and it seems like the ideas never run out. So what do you do to keep that going?
Well, I'm basically interested in life and in people. I observe people. The few times na nakalabas kami during this pandemic, nakatingin ako sa labas, tinitingnan ko sila lahat. Eh. Sabi ko, puro mata. Lahat na nakikita ko, puro mata. Wala mga bibig. Naging mundo ng mga mata. So, I always am interested. Wala akong judgment. I look at people that way. Mula pa noon hanggang ngayon. And I think yun yung endless na river ng pagpasok ng mga ideas at ng mga kwento. Because I don't think maubusan tayo ng kwento eh. Andun lagi ang dami-daming pwedeng isulat eh. Ako, I never felt na maubusan ng kwento. Lalo na yung panahon ng pandemic. Parang tatagilid ka lang, kakanan ka, kakaliwa ka, titingala ka, may maraming kwento na naghihintay ng maikwento natin eh. So, the entire world is bursting with beautiful stories that are waiting to be told. I think it's a crime kung marunong kang magsulat at lalo na kung mahusay kang magsulat and then hindi ka nagkukwento ngayong panahon ito.
That's so inspiring. I'm so inspired just listening to your answers. My goodness, grabe. Thank you so much, Sir Ricky, for your time. Always a pleasure and an honor to talk to you. Please invite everyone to watch Trip to Quiapo.
Please watch Trip to Quiapo on I1TFC starting October 21. Mag-enjoy po kayo at matututo rin at makakapagkwentuhan tayo through the show and even after the show.
You are obviously thriving and we are looking forward to that project of yours with Direct Red and Direct Trev. Maraming salamat!
Thank you.
Subscribe to Cinema's YouTube channel for the latest, the hottest, and most controversial showbiz updates on Cinemanews. Laging kasama.